No, it's just, couldn't you find two BAME actors for Adam and Eve? And I don't know, maybe one much older and bald or visibly disabled or something? Yeah, but you can't see ADHD. BAME. Oh, black, Asian, and minor ethnicities or something. Well, it is important because, you know, I mean, what are we saying here? That the essence of woman and man is being young and pale? Oh, one isn't so pale. Oh, that's good. Yeah, no, I'm sure they're brilliant. I just hope they can sing their dance because, I mean, this is not Chicago, but, you know. Yeah, of course I trust you. Sounds like you've done an amazing job on stepping away. I'm really grateful to you, you know. I really am, and I can't wait to see you all tomorrow. What? What do you mean you're not coming? You're the assistant director. Yeah, I know. You need a day job to be a theatre maker. It's just... I've never directed on my own. I always have an assistant. Okay, yeah, I'll manage. Somehow. Sure, I'll let you know.
Again? Santa Fe, oh, the Santa Fe. There's no name for my Jane, Miss Jane. Santa Fe, she should be no looker, or fun or hooker. Just so you know, she's there. And if she brain turns out to be gay, or is intersex, or defies one sex, well then will you?
Suggesting otherwise. Could there be anything in it? Could it be that we missed something that important all this time?
Well, yeah.
Have you been studying this with the assistant director?
Yes.
Well, why haven't you said so? Okay, well, let's just carry straight on. Okay, so next, I'm sure God reacts, in sense, by all this to Adam and Eve with something like, that's enough. It's here somewhere. Ah, thank you. So, right. That's enough. Why are you doing this?
Oh, you can speak. Well, we tried appealing to you, but you weren't listening, so...
Oh, all this discontent.
Well, we didn't know if you'd ever actually turn up.
How about you try some gratitude?
Oh,
I mean, for God. Stop taking my name in vain.
But, Daddy, why did you punish us?
Why do you question me?
Well, I do, because you know I'm not guilty for original sin, so...
Oh.
So, I think we need an inquiry.
What?
An inquiry?
Yeah.
And, okay, so I'm God. Could be hearing your inquiry.
Well, you would. I mean, you're the judge of all judges. Now, maybe if you listen to us, you'll tell us what you think.
And they can be the jury.
Still need witnesses. I can be their witness.
Oh, I can be the witness.
Are you always on duty?
Well, yes.
Oh, okay. Well, you can be the witness. I mean, you were there too, after all.
Yes, I was there. It says so, Genesis 3. I was there and I will testify.
But you all know that angels can only tell the truth.
I will tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. Well, thanks God.
Yes.
Yeah.
That's all we want.
Okay, so... Okay, let's get this done once and for all. Adam, would you like to start?
Oh, here we go.
Sure.
Have to say.
Okay, so,
Come on, Adam.
So...
You can look at the script, you know.
Yeah, I know. That was... Okay, so I'm suddenly there, in a big place with lots of green stuff and moving things, and I'm thinking everything is basically, you know, fine. I was apparently in a garden, and to me it was basically, you know, perfect. And there are a few basic rules to live by, you know. What did I know? Like, don't eat from the tree or you die. Now, I don't know what dying is, but anyway, I keep away from the tree. Then I get to name the animals, and that was, you know, pretty fun. And then he decides things aren't good with me being alone, and I have to have this operation, and I'm thinking, what's wrong with me? And then when I wake up, Eve is there, and that's, you know, confusing, and then Snake tells us that all that stuff about the tree was a lie, so we eat from the tree, and we don't die, we just see we're naked. But then Daddy gets really upset, I guess, because we found out he'd lied, and then we get cursed, and I get banished, so, I mean, hey Dad, since it was all a lie, what did we do so wrong?
How dare you call me a liar? I am not hearing this anymore. This is not good.
God, this is an inquiry and you agreed to it.
Yes, well, I don't like it now and I can change my mind.
But that would look too good though, would it?
Well, I've done it plenty of times before. Once I even drowned them all.
Yes, but people followed you blindly then. Now things have changed. So you either do away with this lot and start creation all over again, or maybe give them a chance?
Well,
can God be this flighty?
Well, look, they're likely to fry themselves up in about 50 years anyway, so I don't know.
But no, I'm not flighty. I'm actually just experimenting. I mean, seeing what's good and what's not, you know.
Oh, don't look so worried now. Okay, let's carry on.
Eve, it must be your turn now.
Go ahead.
So, I'll be honest, I'm not feeling fairly treated here. I mean, I hate to come across as a whinger. I've been given some lovely things. The garden's gorgeous, the animals are lovely, and Adam's, well, cute enough. But here I stand, cursed. I never meant to do anything wrong. Yes, Adam did tell me about the tree, and he told me not to touch it or eat the fruit or we would die. told me that, and was dying bad anyway. So when Snake said to eat the fruit that our eyes would be open and we'd be more like God, well, of course I was interested. I mean, I love God. But Adam was next to me as well, and if you don't believe me, look in the Bible. And he didn't say don't or stop. No, he had some too. So we all got cursed and I got lumbered with the blame. And you gave them a reason why you didn't, why you cursed them, but you didn't give me one. And you know why? You didn't have one. You know I didn't go against your word. So you still curse me to desire my husband while he rules over me and give birth in pain.
But I didn't banish you from paradise, did I?
No, and I know, but I thought I'd be a good girl and just follow Adam. But now everyone else thinks I'm guilty.
But that's not my fault, is it? Why don't they read the Bible? I mean, they just repeat and believe what others tell them, isn't that? I mean, you ate the fruit, so everyone can think for themselves.
God, do you need a break?
No, I'm fine.
What kind of a cookie?
Chocolate chip cookie?
Chocolate chip cookies are good.
Now perhaps it's time for me to tell you all what I saw. So I'm from another realm, and I was basically there way before these guys were even made, Genesis 3. So I witnessed the whole thing. I saw God putting that tree bang in the middle of the garden and saying to Adam, but not to Eve, that he shouldn't eat from it. I mean, you put it there and then punished them for succumbing to temptation. I mean, what was the point? Why did you make them at all? And you didn't want them conscious. Well, then hide the tree. Oh, but I forget, you created everything. So don't even make the damn tree. Now, Adam was made to feel that he was not enough. After making him, God indeed said for the first time since starting creation that things were not good with Adam alone. Everything else he'd made before he thought was good. So he cut Adam up to make Eve. Poor Adam. He's the only one not whole in the whole of creation. Is that why you take special care of him? And when Snake spoke to Eve, Adam was actually there, it says so in the old book. He stood there and said nothing. Eve ate the fruit, yes she did, but God, you never told her not to. No, you didn't banish her from Eden, that is crystal clear in the book, but you still cursed her and you couldn't even give a reason for it. And so I ask you all, was that fair?
You had it coming, you had it coming, you only had yourself to blame. If you'd have been there, if you'd have seen it, I bet you you would have thought the same.
I'm bored, man. Storm's off, while the others are up in arms about it. So what's next?
Oh, well, with God gone, Angel takes over the proceedings, calling on the jury to weigh up all that's been said and come up with a verdict.
Okay, sure, go for
it. So, ladies and gentlemen, you are the jury, and thus have a historic opportunity to decide by a show of hands whether you think Eve is indeed guilty or not guilty of the original sin. You've heard the evidence. You've listened to Eve and Adam's woes and pleas. Now it's time to seal Eve's fate. But be warned. You must not be swayed by the lure of this show, or indeed by these truly gifted actors, for that constitutes perjury. Instead, you must vote from your conscience alone. Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, the moment has finally come. Those who find Eve guilty of original sin, please raise your hand.
Honourable jury, the verdict has been cast, and it is that Eve is hereby found not guilty of original sin. Thank you all.
Ready for this? God, would you like to join us up here, please?